Let us introduce some basic mathematical functions provided by Java. We can find out the maximum values or the minimum values quite easily by using the mathematical functions provided by Java. Let us see some examples. Math is a predefined class for us to handle some mathematical operations. We have a max method, which can help you return the maximum value between the two values provided in the parentheses. So 2 and 3.2 are two numbers to be compared. And we can see that the variable called value 1 is a double primitive. So I can accept some decimal values to be put inside value 1. Let me try to run it. Before doing so, I need to print out. Otherwise, the value cannot be shown on the console. Save, run. Okay, 3.2 is printed out because 3.2 is the larger value of the two values shown here. And since the variable value 1 is a double primitive, I can show the decimal places for following the number to be printed. Can the number returned by the max function an integer? Yes. How can we do that? Now, value 2 is an integer primitive, so you can expect that the maximum of 4 and 2 will be stored in this integer primitive. Let me save it, run it. Yes, the value of 4 is being printed, and 4 is an integer, and the result printed is also an integer. Okay. In addition to finding out the maximum, we can find out the minimum using the pretty much the same principle. For this situation, you can expect that I will get minus 0.9 as the answer. Let me run it. Yes, the minus sign is also printed out because the whole thing is a decimal value which can be represented by the double precision. And of course, we can return an integer value for the mean method. We can see this example. Okay, minus 3 is printed out because it is a smaller number of the two values shown here, and the returned value is an integer. There is no decimal places following up, okay? In addition to minimum value and maximum value, we can get the absolute value, which is also a method provided by the math class, which is a predefined class for Java. ABS means the absolute value. So I have to say that we are calling the static method from the math class. So we simply use the class name followed by the method name. What will we get? Yes, the minus sign is ignored. We simply print out the absolute value of the number shown in the parentheses. Of course, we can return an integer if we set the value to be an integer. Okay, the value is now 8. An integer is printed out because I want value 6 to be an integer primitive. So I will get an integer according to this variable declaration. We can also find out the power of two values by using the pow method. Okay, according to the math class of Java, you can see that the pow static method has two arguments, both of which are double values. And the return value of this pow function is a double value. So what does it mean by that? When I return to the source code, these two values will be cast to a double value before we do the operation requested by the pow method. And then, after casting the two values, we will do the operation to return a double value stored in the double primitive called value 7. Let me run it. So you see, we will have 8.0 as the answer coming from the math.pow method. So it is very important to check the documentation of Java to see the return type and the input arguments for the predefined functions. We can also generate some random values with the functions provided by the math class. We can use the math.random method. Let us see the result of running the printing action. Run it. We get a value between 0 and 1. when I run it again, I will get a different value. So the value coming from the random method will be different all the time. So when you run the program once, the value returned by the random method is always changing. I have two more constants to show you, which are quite commonly used. Okay, the first one will be the value of pi, which is around 3.14. And the second constant is known as the natural number, which is about 2.71 something. So these two constants are commonly used in some scientific calculations. When you want to get the more precise values of these two constants, you can always call the math class, and you use the math.pi or math.e to get the more precise values of these two constants. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.